As the sun sets over Caroline Bay, the little blue penguins come out of their nests.
Hello, how are you?
And every night, Peter Bennett's there to meet them.
Everybody calls me Peter Penguin.
He runs Timaru Penguins, a group he established 5 years ago to protect them. Numbers were small back then.
I read in the paper where some young people were chasing these penguins down on the beach. So I put a letter to the editor in the paper and I said, is there anybody who wants to join me and start looking after these penguins?
The population's almost tripled since then. He runs a roster system where volunteers monitor penguin numbers and activity through an evening count. During the day, the little blue penguins venture up to 20 kilometres off the coast, but it's been well documented by Timaru penguins that 24 of them, or 12 pairs, call Caroline Bay home. The penguins are attracting anywhere up to 100 visitors a night, prompting the council to apply for money from the government's Tourism Infrastructure Fund to ensure the birds are kept safe.
It's an area where a lot of the public access the beach, not only to view the penguins, but to go paddleboarding. In the winter, they're allowed to walk their dogs. The penguins nest in the rock area.
They're hoping to build an observation platform similar to this one.
We've got to talk to the Department of Conservation, Bird and Forest, make sure that what we're proposing fits in with the environment and also with the penguins.
And with no sign of little blue penguin numbers increasing nationwide, Peter Bennett says it's everyone's responsibility to look after them.
If I can do enough here for the penguins to grow and get bigger, I'd like to think that my grandchildren can bring their grandchildren down and see them in 50 years' time, you know. I don't think we look after wildlife enough at the moment, and I really think it's time we started thinking, where are we going with what we've got left?
Timaru Council hopes to have its application into the government by the end of the month. Jordan Oppert, One News.